Next speaker is Sri Naresh Gujralji.
Thank you, sir. So how much time do I have?
You have 7 minutes.
Sir, last time you gave me two. Please be a little indulgent.
I rise
to oppose the budget, but at the same time, as a chartered accountant, I commend the finance minister for being very transparent. I've been in this house 14 years, and for the first time at least, the figures are honest. However, sir, the problem is with the fiscal deficit. The pandemic played havoc with our economy. We have a huge fiscal deficit this year and next year. And my worry is, sir, that with this huge fiscal deficit, the prices will go out of hand. There will be huge inflation. We saw once before, after the Lehman crisis, when the government relaxed the fiscal policies, how prices went up, and especially food prices. And sir, this is going to be a double whammy for the poor person of this country who has also lost his jobs. Sir, I would like to say that this government talks always of federalism and cooperative federalism. But at the same time, if you see, in all the states which are going to the polls, lakhs of crores are being spent, except the state of Punjab, perhaps because I think they feel they will not get any seats there. But I think it's extremely unfair. Sir, the finance minister gave the figures of how much procurement has been done, how the figures have gone up 2 times and 3 times. And I commend this government for that, that it's a fact that the MSP was raised. Direct benefits to kisans have been given. Soil cards were given. Insurance has been improved. But then the question arises, why are the farmers on the street? Why are the farmers committing suicide? Why are the farmers in debt? I think this government needs to look at that issue, because the main reason is this government is not thinking out of the box. Sir, this is a Council of States, and I talk of my state, state of Punjab. My farmer is on the street because he feels that the market is going to be snatched away from him. And for that, one will have to go into the history a little bit. Punjab, the state of Punjab, which included Haryana at that time, they came to the country's rescue when we were begging for food from America, PL 480, etc. As a result, when the window opens both for wheat and paddy, FCI was procuring everything that the farmer had to offer. So the farmer had a market at his doorstep. Sir, the small farmer, and Prime Minister himself said 80% are those farmers who have less than a hectare of land. These farmers have a market at the doorstep today. And that is why they're stuck in this wheat-rice cycle. They can take the production risk, but they cannot take the marketing risk. Now they fear that with the opening up with these three black laws, private sector will come in. They will have to go to the private mandis for with their surplus stocks, and they will not get MSP. The Prime Minister said yesterday, both in the Lok Sabha and before that in this house, MSP was there, MSP will be there, MSP is there. But sir, who is procuring at MSP? Only the state agencies. The private sector is not procuring at MSP. And that is what the farmer wants. He wants MSP to be enshrined in law. You do that, the farmer will go home tomorrow morning. But you are reluctant to do that. Now the question arises, what are you going to do to create a market at the doorstep for the farmer? The Prime Minister said, look at the milk farmer, he is doing so well. Yesterday he said, strawberry farmers are doing so well. Sir, look at Gujarat. The farmer there, the milk farmer, is doing well because he has a market at his doorstep. Whatever he produces, the next day Amul picks it up, Mother Dairy picks it up, some private cooperatives will pick it up. Our farmers lack that. And that is why they are stuck, at least for, I speak for Punjab and Haryana, in the wheat-rice cycle. Now, this government, and I commend them, they have now said that 20,000 crores will be given to create a new institution which will fund long-term infra, which is required because short-term funds were being used for financing long-term requirements or infrastructure projects. But sir, why could they not think of something for the farm sector on similar lines? Why should an institution, a banking institution, be created which will fund these cooperatives, the food processing plants, and such things, so that the farmer finds a market at his doorstep? And till such time that you provide a market at the doorstep, please do not take away what they have already. Sir, in an answer to my question in this house, the minister had said 90,000 crores of fruit and vegetables are wasted post-harvest. Why? Because there's no market at the doorstep. And that is why you can tell a farmer, please grow strawberries, but if the strawberries are going to rot on his farm, what does he do with them? He needs to live. And sir, I have...
With this you conclude.
Sorry?
Please conclude now.
Sir, give me 5 minutes at least. I've just spoken 3 minutes.
You are going to speak another 1 or 2 minutes.
A wheat board? Why can't they create a rice board? Why can't they create a vegetable board, fruit boards? Sir, one more thing I want to say. I will end in just give me 2-3 minutes. One is defense expenditure has gone up, which is good. We are faced with serious threat. But sir, buying most modern aircraft or guns is not enough. You have to ensure that your soldiers are motivated. Their morale is there. And the way their spokespeople are abusing the farmers whose children are on the borders, this demotivates them. I don't know what they're trying to do. Sometimes they're called anti-national, sometimes Khalistanis, sometimes terrorists. And I hope that this will percolate down and all their spokespersons will now stop this nonsense which has been going on for so long. Sir, one more thing I would say. Please do not use force with these farmers who are agitating. Please give, I have just a minute, please, don't interrupt. Please, sir, this is, then you must give me extra time if they're going to interrupt.
No, please carry on.
Your time is over. Sir, I have one thing to say, that lathis, the water cannons, barbed fences, these are not going to do anything because those farmers are inspired by our gurus. They are inspired by Shahid Bhagat Singh. And today every farmer is saying, sir, Faroshi ki tamanna ab hamare dil mein hai. Dekhna hai zor kitna. Bazue katil mein hai.
Thank you.
And I can tell you, sir, these farmers will only go home when they can go home and say, Fateh, Fateh, Fateh. They will not go home otherwise. And I'm telling you, either you withdraw these black laws or you provide them MSP for everything that they procure. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. The next speaker is...